Educators. I'm Morgan.
I'm Ashley.
And this is our friend Josh. And this is our first webcast of a little show we like to call I'm Morgan.
She's Morgan.
She's Ashley. Morgan, Ashley.
I think they get it.
Demonstrate the thing.
Well, this item provided by our friend Josh, it can do this or this. And this.
Oh, yeah.
Today, we are going to show you how to effectively communicate with the students in your classroom.
Communicate. Stop it. Why?
We have three teachers with us today to share three key points to communication.
And what three key points would that be, Morgan?
Well, Mr. Moore is going to talk to us about verbal and nonverbal communication.
Ooh.
Miss Buell is going to talk to us about body language and eye level.
Body language.
And Miss Heidley is going to talk to us about proximity to students.
Well, let's take our first trip into Mr. Moore's classroom and see what he can teach us.
Let's go!
Alright guys, so here we got your math homework for the day. I'm not going to read through the directions because they're clearly written at the top for you guys to do it. Here's that. Here's that. Okay, I'm going to be up at my desk working on some important stuff for Mr. Moore time. If you guys have questions, you can come up in like 10 minutes or so. Well, I'm clearly busy here. The directions are on your sheet. Go sit down. I'll come to you when I'm ready.
Jesus. Well, that was an interesting way to talk to your students.
Oh, you don't say, Josh.
Yeah, I do say.
According to the research, it's important to use proper verbal communication skills when talking with your students. These include things like don't raise your voice, remain calm, and speak politely at all times.
So what we just saw was not how to do it.
No, it was not. Let's see how Mr. Moore uses the research to properly communicate with his students verbally in the classroom.
All right, guys, here's your homework for today. If you guys have any questions, just raise your hand. I'll come around and try to help you guys out, right?
I have a question.
Yes, Mrs.
What does this say?
That is cat.
Thank you.
Oh, welcome.
Now let's see how Mr. Moore uses nonverbal communication in his classroom.
Be quiet! This is not nap time! Okay guys, today we're going to be learning about the area of this box. Can anyone tell me what area is? Drawing on the desk, Mr. Wacky.
Well, that seemed a little harsh.
Nah, that's good for him, Josh.
Well, actually, according to the research, it's important to practice nonverbal communication skills in your classroom. An example of this is to use appropriate gestures or actions. You don't want to draw attention to yourself or the student you are correcting. Now, let's see how Mr. Moore uses the research in his classroom to use nonverbal communication with his students.
Can we keep down, please?
Oh, my goodness. Hey, look at this. Oops.
I'm going to go get a drink of water. Get it and walk around a little bit.
Wow, I think Mr. Moore finally gets how to verbally and non-verbally communicate with his students in his classroom, don't you think, Morgan?
I think so. Now let's take a trip to Ms. Buell's classroom to learn about body language. Let's go!
All right, good morning, boys and girls. Today we are going to read a book called The Very Busy Spider. Early one morning, the wind blew a spider across the field. A thin, silky thread trailed from her body. The spider landed on a fence post near a farmyard and began to spin a web with her silky thread.
Wow, that teacher sure looks lazy.
Yes, she does.
According to our research, there are three main things you want to keep in mind when talking about body language. The first is eye contact. The second is your posture. And the third is facial expressions.
Those seem like three very good points.
Mm-hmm. Let's go back to Ms. Buell's classroom and see if she can do it correctly this time.
Good morning, boys and girls. How are you this morning?
Good.
Good. All right. Well, we are going to start our day off by reading The Very Busy Spider by Eric Carle. That sounds exciting.
Yeah.
You guys like spiders?
No.
No. Okay. Early one morning, the wind blew a spider across the field. A thin, silky thread trailed from her body. The spider landed on a fence post near a farmyard and began to spin a web with her silky thread. Do you guys see the silky thread? Okay. Nay, nay, said the horse. Want to go for a ride? The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. Do you guys want to feel the web? It's starting to grow. Does that feel cool?
Yeah.
Whoa, that was 100 times better. Miss Buell really learned about how to use her body language. Now let's take a trip to Miss Hively's classroom and learn about proximity. Ashley, where's the thing? Let's go.
The Tuckers took a family vacation to Texas last year. They camped in the middle of the trees and watched the sunset each evening. They stayed in a tent. At night, they looked at the stars and enjoyed the view. They washed their hands in a water bucket and took turns emptying and filling it. The Tuckers helped each other when they needed it during their trip. Each Tucker took their turn and brushed their teeth and combed their hair each morning and night. They had baked lots of food before they left to eat while they were gone. All they had to do was heat it up. The Tuckers loved their family vacation in a tent in Texas. Now I want you to complete the word sort that you have on your paper. And you'll do that individually, and then we'll talk about it when you're done. Are there any questions? Yes.
I have a question. I don't really understand it. Can you come help me?
What don't you understand?
The whole thing.
She didn't even move, like, the entire time.
Yeah, you don't say, Josh. According to research, students respond better and increase their attention when the teacher is close to them. To gain or hold their attention, they should stand or sit near them. When talking to him, don't you think?
Right. So she should have gone over to the student's desk.
Let's see how Ms. Hively uses research in her classroom.
In Texas. Okay, now you're going to complete the word sort that's on your paper, and when you're done, we're going to talk about it. Are there any questions?
Wow, I really think those guys nailed it.
Yeah, they really taught us a lot about communicating with students in their classroom.
I think I'm ready to be an educator now.
You want to be a teacher, Morgan?
I do. Thanks for tuning in to our first webcast of iMorgan.
Tune in next time when we introduce my cat to skydiving.
Now it's time for... Hey there, future educators. Oh,
we're stopping.
And this.
Oh, yeah.
Today, we are going to.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah, though. That works.
Yeah. Proper communication when I don't know what I just said.
Well, she sure looks like a lazy teacher, don't you think?
Yes, she does.
According to research on body language, there are three main things you want to keep in fucking do it right, Josh. I was supposed to say it?
Yes.
I thought Ashley 100 times better. Miss Buell really learned how to use her body language. Let's go take a trip to Miss Hively's classroom now to what are we learning?
Why are you looking at me?
I don't know. I forgot.
It sucks.
Proximity!